After being in orbit for almost 28 years, the Hubble Space Telescope may be coming to its end. But does it really have to be? Hubble's expecting a companion soon, known as the James Webb Space Telescope. Hubble's mission is expected to last into the 2020s, and the new young James Webb is expected to launch in 2019, which means for that 1 year, the two observatories will be working hand in hand in collaborative data. But when Hubble comes close to its end, what's next? Hubble's been in space for almost 3 decades. The equipment has been highly exposed to solar radiation in lower Earth orbit. The fine guidance sensors, which are some of the original electronics from the very start of the mission, are beginning to degrade due to those high radiation levels. Hubble's had 5 service missions, and its camera housing has been hit many times by space debris, like it actually has impact craters. So obviously, Hubble's been through quite a lot. And now, here comes James Webb, which isn't replacing Hubble, but instead complementing it. These observatories are very different from one another. Hubble's images and data are found mainly in the visible and ultraviolet wavelengths. It led to discoveries like supermassive black holes being the center of most, if not all, galaxies. And it even confirmed the expansion of the universe. James Webb, however, will be mainly focused on the infrared wavelengths, and because the mirrors have 6.25 times more collecting area than Hubble, it will be able to see way further into the universe than Hubble ever could. That's including seeing galaxies that formed in the very beginning of our universe. But still, the main question now is what to do with Hubble once its batteries die out, which will happen eventually. We've got some options before then. We can move it into a safe parking orbit somewhere, kind of making it into a space museum. Or we could send a mission to Hubble to prepare it for guided re-entry and landing to Earth. A lot of scientists feel, though, if we do send a mission up to Hubble, then why don't we just refurbish and keep it in service instead? But now, here it is in 2018, and there's still no solid plan for what to do with this telescope. If by 2020 we decide to crash land the observatory, we can control its landing by 2028. But according to NASA's report on it, the Hubble Space Telescope won't naturally deorbit before 2027. Otherwise, if we just leave it alone, it will naturally deorbit itself and crash land somewhere on Earth. I don't know about you guys, but I vote for Hubble being put in service again. With an ever-expanding universe, we can use all of the incredible instrumentation that we have to discover more in our cosmos. Deorbiting is not a huge deal. There's a very low chance it would hit anyone. But Hubble is very big. How big? Find out in Trace's video right here. Remember when Hubble needed fixing after it launched? Its optical issues were obviously repaired, and now this technique is used today in mammograms to detect breast cancer months sooner than other methods.